going to read to you the second part of The Godmother of Elftwinkel and Her New Friends. Chapter 5. On Their Way to Twinkle's Godmother. After the three friends had had a good rest on the hilltop, they prepared for the next part of their journey. The ice cave of Twinkle's godmother lay at the foot of the hill between weathered gray boulders. Downhill it went quickly, and Twinkle gave clues to follow a narrow path. To his surprise, the wizard noticed that they stood still by an opening in the ground, which was barely visible within half a circle of stacked stones. "This is the entrance," said Twinkle. "It goes straight down at first, and then there's a tunnel." "Isn't it quite dark under the ground?" asked the wizard. The little elf nodded. "There's a tinderbox below and torches. They are small, but if we both carry one, there will be enough light." For Tobias, it wasn't difficult to see in the dark, and they decided that he would go first with Twinkle on his back. The friends went down through the opening where the uneven pieces of rock formed a crude staircase. The wizard had to bend over and followed his friends, who almost disappeared in the dark. He hoped they could soon lit the torches. "How moist and cold it's in here," he thought, while he walked through the tunnel, touching the walls to find his orientation. Meanwhile, Tobias walked with Twinkle on his back over the rocky ground, without a sound. His ears pricked, his eyes wide open, and with his nose sniffing the smells which came out of the tunnel. Twinkle whispered in his ear, "Just a little more and we'll find the torches." A tiny glow of light appeared before them through a crack in the rocks above them. "Look, there they are," pointed Twinkle, and the friends stood still in a high, dimly lit place. The wizard looked around, relieved, and noticed the ice crystals shimmering on the walls. Twinkle let herself slide off Tobias, walked to the tinderbox and made fire. The wizard picked up two torches and lit them. Twinkle climbed back on her worn place and took her torch from the wizard's hand. Tobias looked a little troubled and said, "Mind you, don't set me afire, please." And he moved his ears flat against his head. Twinkle laughed and said, "Madcap, don't fret. I hold it as high as possible." And while she held the torch above her head, she looked at the wizard and asked, "Ready to go?" Their shadows on the wall were dancing, and the shadow of the long, sharp nose of the wizard went up and down a couple of times. They continued their journey through the tunnel. The wizard didn't feel so cold anymore, and accompanied by the yellow torchlight, he looked around with curious eyes. Deeper and deeper they descended the hill, and icicles appeared on the walls with curtains of ice too. Every so often, the bottom was covered with ice, and one time they had to cross a frozen lake. Tobias put a paw gently on the ice, then the other one, and the following, another step. Whoosh! His legs spread to four directions. The wizard laughed when he saw Tobias flat on his stomach, and Twinkle giggled. The sound reflected from all sides and sounded so hollow and frosty that they stopped immediately, quite startled. The wizard reached down, lifted the belly slider, walked with him to the other side and put him back on his four legs again. "Are you okay?" he asked as he stroked Tobias over his back. Tobias meowed and Twinkle understood. "What on earth?" She tickled him behind his ear and said, "No more slides from now on, so don't worry." Tobias began to purr and enjoyed it with half-closed green eyes. They rested for a little while, sitting by the warm light of their torches, and ate a handful of nuts, which the wizard had taken from his backpack. "I hope your godmother wants to receive us," he said. "Does she leave the hill at all?" "Hardly ever, lately," said Twinkle. "She's afraid of the sun. She can only endure the white light in her icy cave." The wizard was in thought and understood that Twinkle's godmother lived in trying times. "We've got nothing for her to offer. Do you think that's bad?" he asked. "What we can offer her is always with us, and that's kindness. In your eyes I can see there are a lot of that," replied Twinkle, and she looked at him while the same was present in her eyes. The wizard grew very shy and started to stroke Tobias, who lay at his feet. Chapter 6. The Visit to the Ice Cave. The last part of the journey in the hill had started, and the three friends walked between irregular ice forms and huge icicles. The torches were no longer needed. A white light shone from the ice walls and left everything glistening in ice blue and silver. It was like a fairy tale in which three strangers of flesh and blood were lost. Twinkle stood on the shoulder of the wizard, and Tobias was hidden under his jacket, with his head behind his beard, and he sneezed. Twinkle giggled and pulled the beard aside. "Shh," she said, and put a finger to her lips. "Get that tickling thing away," Tobias said. "Put a knot in it for all I care." That was an excellent idea, and moments later she burst out laughing when the wizard looked along his nose to his beard, rather dumbfounded. "What an idea," he said with a half smile. "It's Tobias' idea," Twinkle said. Your beard is tickling his nose." "Ah, is that so?" he said, and the beard in the knot jiggled and Twinkle had to sit down with laughter. "Shh," she told herself with a bright green head, and they continued in silence. When Twinkle saw a light shining through an opening before them, she jumped up and whispered in the ear of the wizard, "We have arrived. Please put me down. I'll go in first." The wizard let her step down on his hand, and moments later Twinkle walked on her little legs through the opening of the ice cave, a green elf in the middle of silver-blue ice. In the middle of the cave was an ice mound. Right above it hung long icicles, like bars of a prison. Inside was a white, unmoving statue, upright and foreboding. No sound was audible, other than the sound of tinkling glass when an icicle broke off. "Good day to you, Godmother. Your godchild elf Twinkle is here," she spoke in a tinkling voice. Nothing moved. Everything was rigid and frozen. Twinkle walked up the stairs to the ice throne, where her godmother was sitting, and noticed that she was completely covered with a layer of ice. Through it, Twinkle could still see some of her godmother's face, and she moved her head close to that of her godmother. The eyes of her godmother opened, and she looked at Twinkle, begging for help in silence. "Godmother, you are freezing," said Twinkle, and she started to cry green tears while she wrapped her green arms around the icy statue. It was just as well that her godmother could not talk with her frozen mouth, otherwise she would have said, "Child, don't be silly. Behave yourself." To be as close as she was right now, Twinkle had never experienced, and she cried because she felt how she missed her godmother. Her green tears fell on the ice and made it melt. Water trickled down and the head of godmother began to thaw. Chapter 7. Elf Twinkle presents her friends. Now the tears were also tears of joy, which fell on the harness of Twinkle's godmother. She looked into the eyes that were as green as those of herself and said, "Godmother, I've brought two friends. They are waiting outside in the corridor." There was no answer, and Twinkle decided to get the others. She walked down the stairs and returned through the opening she had come through earlier. She beckoned them to come closer, and a few moments later they were all standing in front of the ice throne. "Godmother, these are the wizard and his cat Tobias," said Twinkle. The mouth of godmother was still frozen, and Twinkle beckoned her friends to come closer as she ascended the stairs. The wizard looked in amazement at the icy statue and the rods of ice around it. while he walked up the stairs with Tobias in his jacket. Then he saw the green eyes looking at him, startled, and he said, "Hello, godmother of Twinkle. I came along because I'm asked to help. She has told me that you were frozen. Is there anything I can do for you?" Silently they looked at each other, and under his kind blue-eyed look, the green eyes filled with melted tears. Now the ice pack also began to thaw from the inside, and slowly the head of Godmother began to show itself. The wizard and Twinkle sat down on the stair steps and waited. Tobias looked from his warm place at the silver-blue brilliance around him. "No stove, no soft blanket to lay on, no spot of sunlight. Brr, not for me," he thought. He looked up at the ice statue and met two green eyes that looked with huge surprise at him. Now he understood that this had to be the godmother of Twinkle, and he said, "Meow, do you like the cold?" This time there was an answer from the mouth of Godmother. "Don't you ask such a rude question, hairy beast." Well, it was clear that Godmother's condition had improved. Twinkle bit her tongue to stifle her laughter behind the ear of the wizard, which showed humor sparkles in his eyes for a moment. Then he said politely, "Are you okay with us sitting here with you? Or do you want us to go away?" "Oh no, it was very wise of Twinkle to take you here. I can hardly move. You must help me," was Godmother's Ice Queen haughty reply. "Well, you have to thank Twinkle that you can speak again, miss, and I want to hear from you while you are living here, freezing to death almost," he said, pinning her down properly. The frightened green eyes of Godmother looked in those of the wizard, and for a moment all was quiet. "Well, I'll tell you why," she said, with a deep sigh. A crack in the ice pack around her neck appeared. Chapter 8, The Story of Twinkle's Godmother. "You should know," she began, "that I grew up in the dark forest. We lived in an old bird's nest high in an oak, and in summer the blue sky was our school and playground. I was happy to be up in the air, day and night, with my family, and I came home late in the evening, often too late. As punishment, I got no food, and I had to sit in a corner alone. They found me a weird one and teased me, calling me Tiny Blue. While they didn't dare to go beyond the edge of the forest, and I always brought cherries from the riverside further away. It was the most delicious dessert, which everyone relished in, and yet they never thanked me." The green eyes of Godmother filled again with tears that fell onto the ice pack around her chest. The three friends at her feet saw the ice melt and were silent. "As autumn came, I was bored always in the oak tree, and the storm and the rain ruined our home, so we spent the winter on the ground. There it was dark and stuffy. I hate those wet, sticky leaves and fungi. I didn't understand that my family was able to sit all winter in a dark hole and peel beech nuts. On a winter's day, I couldn't stand it any longer and made a long trip on the back of a wolf. He brought me to this hill and crawled into the tunnel, the one that you've just walked through. And so I've discovered this ice cave." She interrupted her story by looking around her at the ice palaces she had carved out in the course of time. This was her blue sky, where it is always clean and clear, and where she could make everything to her liking. She was lonely, though, and it was always cold. No one knew of its existence and her whereabouts in the beginning. "It was my secret," she continued her story, "and nobody teased me here. Even the storm and rain didn't affect me and my world here. More often I fled from home to this place and stayed away for the night. I made music on these ice rods and began to carve ice sculptures. And so I made my home, my ice palaces, and I felt more and more at home in it. When I told my family that I had found a home that never broke down, where it never smelled bad, and that I planned to live there, no one protested, and I think they were happy that I left. Now there were new tears flowing, And the wizard looked at her with kind eyes. How difficult it must have been for you to be so alone and never hearing a kind word from someone, he said. You have such special gifts and chooses to do things that others don't dare to even think of, which I find very courageous. One could hear a sob coming from Godmother, and the remnants of the ice pack around her chest burst into pieces. Twinkle made a little jump on the shoulder of the wizard and said, I'm so happy that I'm able to hear your story, and I find you very brave. Her godmother sighed deeply for a few times and felt that she finally began to feel a bit of warmth returning in her body. Chapter 9. Godmother continues her story. My family never came for a visit to see how I live here, and when I came out, I did it at night, preferably at full moon, when everything is so beautifully blue-white, a bit like here in the ice cave. I was afraid that the sun would melt the ice, and I got pain in my eyes as soon as I went out in daylight. With time, I couldn't endure the light of the sun by day. Twinkle is the only one who comes here to visit me, and even though you are my godchild, I'm always afraid that you will tell weird things about me to the family. That is why you know so little about me. She looked at Twinkle, which was sitting on the shoulder of the wizard, listening with green ears. But godmother, I hardly ever see the family, and all I know of them is that they think you're happy here. They don't know that I visit you and long to see you. There's no one who makes such beautiful ice palaces like you, and then you also create such special music. But inside you were beginning to freeze, and you became so strict lately. There were a few tears falling from Twinkle's eyes on Tobias' nose, and he shook his head. Godmother also shed tears, but she laughed anyway at Tobias, who looked up in surprise when he heard a sound like glass tinkling. The wizard smiled when he saw that she was not as strict as she looked. He opened his jacket, picked up Tobias and said, be a little stove for her, and put Tobias down next to her on the throne. The green eyes of Godmother grew big with fright, while Tobias folded his legs under him. She looked with open mouth at the hairy beast, then to the two at her feet and couldn't utter a word. Twinkle began to giggle at the funny face of her godmother, and the wizard showed his humor sparkles in his eyes. Then she surrendered and laughter echoed through the ice cave. If it was because of the sound, no one knows, but the ice bars around her broke into pieces with a loud tinkling.